In this video, I'm going to start out by showing you my MMO code a little bit. So one of the issues we're having in our starter room in the tutorial series is that we don't have enough energy to sort of keep things moving along at the maximum pace. So in order to fix that, we're going to create a few new roles here. Instead of having a creep go to the energy source, mine, and then go come to its destination and perform an action, we're going to have a dedicated creep that only moves to the source, mines it completely every 300 ticks. So here in MMO, I have this set up. There's this tractor role, which moves energy from the sources to the storage, and there's a farmer role, which moves to each energy source and gathers it out entirely. And this little system is expandable, because here's a tractor coming from the next room over. On the Slack forums, we've named this remote harvesting, but essentially what that means is that there's a center room, and there's additional rooms nearby that are being also harvested for their energy. And the code gets a little more complicated as you're having to deal with things like invader cores and enemy creeps in the room. But for now, let's just build a system that can identify all the sources within a room, and then in the next video we can create one that will spawn a harvester unit and move to each one of those sources. So going back over to our little game world here, we have two sources in the room. So let's go back to our script and write a maybe like a room utility of some sort. So identify sources. So our function, I'll probably end up moving this code eventually, but for now this works. So back to our harvester role, we have a function that finds nearby energy sources. So in harvest energy, stored source, harvest, it's right here. Going back over to rooms, let sources equal room.findFindSources. And what I want to do with this is actually store it in memory so we can use it later. So we're going to do let room.memory sources equal a new object. So this will be in the memory. We don't need a let actually, we just need this for each sources. So for every source in that array, we're going to do this. We're going to pass that source into a function. And we're going to do source.position. So what I want to create is an array, not an array, an object of the room name, and then for each one of those objects we'll have some data. So we'll have things like the source ID as the key, and inside of the data we'll have when the last creep was spawned, how much energy is left, things like that. So what we want to get first is the name of the room. Equal, which will just be room.name. So that's resources. Room.name. Equals new object type, and then what we'll do is go over to here and we'll do this whole thing in the setter. Room.memory, resources, room.name, and the value will be source.id. And we're just going to put an empty that the current data equal that. So if there's nothing in that data, we want to set it. So if it's completely empty, we're going to do this code. Otherwise, we're just going to skip. Now let's go over to MMO, not MMO, but the local server, and let's take a look at rooms. And there should be one called resources, and the room name is the key, and the two source IDs. And currently there's no data in those, but we'll use these. Maybe what I want to do is break this down. So eventually I want to have things in this little resources tab like the minerals and the actual source IDs. Yeah, let's go one lower with this guy. Resources, room name, comma. Energy. And then we'll have to delete that guy. Energy. Okay, cool. So now we have an object with each one of the sources, and eventually what we'll do is we'll have multiple rooms within this, and the code that spawns the unit to go mine out the source will cycle through each one of those whenever it's running its spawn code, looking for ones that don't currently have a miner attached. And also in that, we can have other data. Like, maybe we have a field that says under attack. And then if it's true, spawn a defender. Or we have code like needs a builder, needs a creep to lay down roads or repair structures, things like that. So we can have all this data. It's sort of persistent tick to tick stored here. But for now, that is fine. I think we don't need this code to run constantly. So let's do this. If game.time modulo 500 equals equals 0. So if it's a 500th tick, run this identify sources code. So the next thing that we're going to want to do is create an actual creep that uses that code to spawn. We'll probably do that here in room.spawning. Do we have room? We have the room type. Get that data first from the other. Right here. Room up memory resources room. We don't need this. We need, gather all of that resource data for each resource data. So what target room is going to be is resource data is going to be a top level node. So over here in memory, that's going to be this W7N4. And one cool thing we can do here is we can do data comma key. We can do console log. To do a json.stringify here so you can actually see the data rather than just having it be listed as an object type. So here we have energy, and the key is the room name, and under energy we have the two sources. So here what we're going to do is for each data so source ID is going to be the key, not the key, the key of each node in the next layer down. Console log. Source ID game.get object by ID. That does. unexpected token on 44, 43. Yep. Make sure your brackets always line up. Save. Is this code running every tick? Oh, okay, so it's only running if there's not a creep spawning. We want to run this code while we're testing, at least, for every tick. So let's go up here and just paste it above this return statement. Object and null. For each data. So we have a problem here. We need to do data.energy. Yep. So we have object types. Null. Okay, so the problem here is that we have a object, and then we have null because we can't get the object ID of this. We need to be passing instead this value. So same issue here. We need to do what are you gonna call this? Values, source ID. Okay, so now it's grabbing the source ID and the actual source value. But what we can do with this now is we can store the last time that a creep was spawned, and if that time is greater than the creep lifetime, we know that a new one needs to be spawned. So doing things like that, we can actually build the spawning code. So if I use that last spawn, well, I use that last spawn with the last time that a creep was attempted to spawn. So game.time is the current tick value. So we'll do game.time minus values that last spawn. If that is greater than creep lifetime, I believe that's the constant. Screeps API documentation, reference, constants. Yeah, creep lifetime is 1500. What we can do is, so if it's been more than 1500 ticks since the last spawn, we'll do a little code like this. should we call this guy? In G minor. Keep this consistent. Spawns 0. And we'll move all this code back down below spawn so we actually have that to work with. Let's see what happens. Something's wrong with this line of code right here, game.time. Let's see what it is. False. Okay, let's do console log. See the value of it's undefined. Let's do this. Values not last bond or 0. Yep, that works. Let's not forget to set last spawn here. See if we can set it dynamically like this. Otherwise, we're just going to have to create the full path and set the value from there. Here. Cannot read property run of undefined. Oh, okay. So there's no energy minor role. So that's the issue here. Just copy over Harvester for now and make that the default code. Seems to be working. And let's add another value to the memory. Source ID will be that, And we need to put in the target room. See if that works. So now last spawn did work. Let's delete last spawn. It's spawning another, it's spawning a harvester right now, but see if it will spawn the energy miner. And does that energy miner, yes, it has a source ID, it has a target room, so now using this source ID, which is the one we defined in right here, we can write some code to make it move to the target source, which is here. Do things like put down a container to mine into and repair that container, build that container. We can have it request backup if there's an attack on the room, things like that. This little system, we're going to need to clean up this code. Right now it's really messy. And start building these out into functions rather than having just copy-paste. But eventually we'll have a working system right now here for energy mining in the current room and as well as the neighboring rooms. Using this value right here in the creep, the target room, we can do a check. If the target room is the same as the room name that the creep's currently in, you're good, run the code. Otherwise, move to the target room first. Something like that will be the code. Anyway, in the next video, we're going to be going over how to clean this guy up a little bit more, and actually building out the role file for Energy Miner.